One of the great things that you can do is to pray for divine timing. And when you started out in the beginning of the week praying for divine timing, you will be surprised at the marvelous things that happen at just the precise right time in your week. In Ecclesiastes 3, verse 17, it says, "For he has appointed a time for every matter and for every work." Well, I pray that divine timing is the standard for your life and the activities of your life this week. If opportunities or events appear to be happening too soon or too late, you affirm in prayer divine timing. Relaxed and patient, you can understand that all things are working together for your good. God is on your side and creating a wondrous divine timing in your life. If you feel pressured in any way by approaching due dates for completing work, and haven't we all, or perhaps paying bills, or perhaps achieving goals, you affirm divine timing and divine order. And then you're able to plan and act in the light of divine timing. You cooperate with divine order and divine timing by doing your best and by expecting positive outcomes. And that's a biggie. You'd be surprised how many people don't. They expect the worst. They expect Murphy's Law to work of if anything bad can happen, it will. Well, I ask you this week to not only work with divine timing, but to expect best outcomes. To have that kind of faith in you. The higher order of divine timing is working in and through all people and events in your life. You trust God's law of right timing. Trusting in divine timing, you understand that too soon or too late, well, they're concepts of timing, not God's. As you let go of any need to push or force things, which I've done so many times in the past, gads, what a waste of energy. You let God's perfect timing work in your life. So I pray for you, my friend, that this week is a week of God's divine timing.